Hi, this is Jeff Gelman of Solid Canine Training doing the downstay. Downstay is an extremely practical command. Here you see me at an Italian festival with five dogs and my two kids in downstays. So what is the downstay command? The downstay command is where you put your dog into a position where he's lying down. Once you have given him the down command, your dog cannot get up under any circumstances until you release him. When do we use the downstay? Outdoor cafes, restaurants, festivals, parties, picnics, mowing the lawn, cleaning, cooking, when the children are playing outside, during conversations.
Just to give you an example of how long Sassy's been here, when we first started this video, it was the 24th of the month. It's now the 27th of the month, so she's been here for 3 days. Actually, we just filled up the memory card 15 minutes ago, and we had to empty out the card into the computer, and came back and Sassy's still lying down here. So it actually has been about 10, 15 minutes and I haven't even been next to her because I didn't really think much of it. I don't even have to pay attention to her. She knows that down is down. So when you get her home and she doesn't down for you, she's being disrespectful to you. She's trying to be...
So how do we teach the downstay? The following clips are a step-by-step slideshow on how to most effectively teach the downstay. We are going to first start with our dogs in the heel position with our dog sitting next to us. We will be grabbing the leash 6 to 8 inches from the buckle with our left hand. We will say the word down and we will push the dog to the ground with our hand. So the leash goes right to the ground and your dog should follow. Do not worry if your dog makes any noise or squirms. Keep your hand down to the ground. It's very important that we don't release the tension until our dog is all the way down. Once they're all the way down, we release a little bit of tension, which allows the head to pop up. Keep in mind that at no time should your hands be on any part of your dog. This is a command that we do with a leash and a collar. So we don't want to be pushing down on our dog, we want to be pushing down on the leash. What you can also do is once the leash is to the ground and your dog is in a relaxed state, you can always put your foot on the leash, which will give it that extra security if your dog decides to get up. One of my other methods that I really like to use the down is using your foot to down your dog. Now what you're going to do is you're going to have your dog in the heeling position, sitting down on your left hand side. You will drop your hand of the left side so the leash falls out, creating a U with the leash. You will then pick up your left leg and you will step down on the leash so the pressure of the leash will drive your dog into the down position. It's very important that you leave your foot on the ground. If you lift your foot up and the dog is not yet down, your dog will pop back up. Another very helpful hint you can use is by using the leash as a lever. So with your foot on the ground and if your dog is not going into the down, you can pull the leash up with your foot on the ground. And this again will bring your dog's head, which then the body will follow, to the ground. This is a highly effective way of doing this. I know it might be uncomfortable for you to watch your dog doing this, but it is highly effective. This next video is a demonstration of myself with Keeley downing two dogs. Notice how the dog I am with needs a little bit of help. Also notice how you do not hear us say stay, because down means downstay.
So you obviously saw Shadow go down much easier. Sassy needed a little bit of a reminder. All I did was step on the leash very, very gently. I could have just as easily popped on the leash, but I didn't feel like bending over. Now, with two of them here, stay still means stay. Down means down stay. The only thing we said to them was down. They can do this for over an hour. No problem with lots of distractions. So if you get home and they break immediately, they're not being respectful of you and they don't look at you as the pack leader. They think they run the show. This is huge. This is going to be huge for their overall obedience, for their behavior, for the rest of their life. If you can't enforce this downstay, they're being disrespectful. Therefore, I'm going to need you to just crack down on the basics and make sure they stay here. Inches away from their face.
The next few slides are different practical ways that downstays will help you. This is my morning walk. I'm with six dogs. We walk about 4 miles. This is Patch. He's in a downstay while my kids play on the equipment outside. This is Subo. This is a dog that's been aggressive towards children in the past. And look how practical the downstay is. This is one of my favorite photos, and there's actually a video that comes along with this. My dogs, Max and Uma, are an incredible downstay while I race through them with a bicycle. This is outside of Starbucks when I'm working on some, probably my blog or some work. I'm with 5 dogs, all in great downstays. Lots of dogs coming by. Another beautiful photo. People download this photo all the time. Max, Uma, and Bella, 3 of my dogs.
And then go up to her and give her some love. Underneath the chin. Good. And walk away. Good. Do it again. Good.
Yeah.
Good. And I want you to go over to your her water bowl and stick your finger in it. Good. Jump over. Good.
Here's another great downstay with 5 dogs outside of a cafe. A special 4th of July downstay with Uma, with sparklers going. This is with a client. Now, where those folks are all standing, cars would go back and forth and these dogs would not move. This is at the Ironman race. Hundreds and hundreds of runners, bikers, swimmers would go by in the back of a client's backyard. So look at all these pictures. These are real life pictures of things that you would really be in the situation for. That's what's great about my training. It's real world training.
Good job, Clover.
Yeah.
Thank you for watching Downstays Part 1. Please watch Downstays Part 2.